Hey, 안녕하세요. We're here in Daegu, South Korea, and yeah, I haven't really walked around the neighborhood yet because I just moved here this week. So let's go walk around and see what's up. Just got a new microphone too, so gonna test, see if the audio quality improves. Yeah, let's go check it out. We are walking around town, Daegu, on a Saturday, and it's pretty quiet. Largest city in Korea. Okay, and supposedly that very large building is a Korean spa and gym. The Jiljibang, whatever they're called. I'm gonna go check that out. Another cafe. It's like every other shop is a cafe. Cheeseburgers. Ventured off to a quieter part of Daegu, and there's a park to the right here, so just have to figure out how to get inside of that and yeah, might be a good view from the top. Yeah, it's now December now, and it's actually a very nice day. It was very cold the other day, but since Daegu's more to the southern part of Korea, it doesn't get too cold in winter, I've heard. At least not as cold as Seoul. Some nature in this concrete jungle, which is Daegu. This seems to be the entrance to the park. Pretty elevated. Let's see if we can get to the top. Oh, mountain top. This way. It's interesting right there. Shoe vacuum, I guess, to blow off the dirt from your shoe after you go hiking. That's pretty interesting. Never seen that before in my life. But anyway, I guess I'll use it on the way back down. I could this is interesting because it's actually padded. It looks like they put like some kind of carpet or something on the trail, so you don't even have to step in the dirt. Yeah, seems like Korea very much cares about the cleanliness of your feet. So, can't wear your shoes indoors. Can't hike without a carpet. And yeah, and then you have to use a leaf blower to dust off your feet. So that's interesting. Okay, and in case hiking is not enough exercise, it looks like there's also a gym on the way to the summit of the mountain. So I guess you can do your arms, get your cardio in. Sure what that exercise was for, but apparently fitness is very big in Korea. Alright, let's get up this mountain. Getting high. In Korea. Yeah, this is actually a very nice hike. It wasn't too long. Very short hike. Had a free gym halfway up the mountain. And it's pretty peaceful. It's pretty quiet here. So I guess Korean people come here to escape the concrete jungle, which is all that there. And being that Korea is such a small country, I guess they really appreciate these little parks scattered around. And yeah, it's pretty nice. Going up. looks like people, looks like those are apartment buildings on that side. Alright, we made it. Made it down the mountain. Try the shoe leaf blower thing. If that did anything, but I guess it blew off some dust from my shoes. Pretty cool. So that's something new I learned today. Okay, and it is 2:00. 2:00. Yeah, so I guess next I'm gonna go, I haven't been to a cafe yet, actually, in Korea, so I think next I'm gonna go find the most interesting cafe I can find and get a latte. Yes, I still don't have data on my phone, so I'm just gonna have to wander around until I find something. Hey bird! Alright, here's an interesting cafe. It's called Finger Coffee. There's also a Cafe Bom Bom right there. Finger Coffee did not take Visa, unfortunately, so I can't get coffee here, but interesting concept. I'm not sure what the finger has to do with anything, but it's open 24 hours and self-serve, and there's even literally one seat in this cafe, so interesting. Let's go look for another cafe somewhere. We found... So it is a... coffee aquarium. So Cafe Aquarium was really good. The staff was super friendly. Coffee was like $3 for the latte, which is about like half the price you would pay in the US, or at least in New York. And yeah, it was good. It was good coffee. Some fish. Totally recommend it.